Well, thank you, Josh. And mosquito control programs are already in high gear. That's because the winter's high snowfall has left us with copious amounts of standing water, and with it, an increased number of mosquito larvae.
In towns like Derry and Salem, on Monday, crews from Dragon Mosquito Control started checking on areas where there is shallow, stagnant water.
We have a lot of swamps, a lot of big permanent swamps, as we refer to them, red maple swamps, cedar swamps, and those are the perfect habitats for the triple E mosquito.
Sarah McGregor, president of Dragon Mosquito Control, says last year's dry summer resulted in very few mosquitoes, but this summer looks to be a different story.
Right now we are seeing very high numbers, and I'm a little nervous. It's awfully early to be seeing the number and the size mosquitoes that we're finding.
And proposed cuts in the House version of the state budget are creating more nervousness. Dr. Jose Montero says the money may be severely reduced that HHS uses to test birds and samples for Triple E and West Nile.
In the front of what we do for trapping and testing, we're still trying to figure out if we can get any alternative federal funds. As of today, that's not the case, but we're still working on it.
State reimbursement to individual towns for mosquito control costs could also take a hit. But McGregor says towns pay up front, and she thinks without the reimbursement, most still will be able to move forward.
It certainly helps to ease the tax burden, and I think it's just disappointing to see that money cut.
Well, the number of positive test results dropped last year, but state officials say that was because there was a reduction in the number of mosquitoes tested because budgets had already been trimmed. Public health officials won't start mosquito testing until July 1st, but McGregor says now is the time to act to get the mosquitoes in check. Live in the studio, I'm Suzanne Rountree, WMUR News 9.